really that has a bar, because it's not sanctioned. Which makes it quite a deal more fun. Play a lot of it. buddies. He decided to buy power, so now I can use the Brockton.
Oh yeah. No, no. Oh yeah. Sorry. I'm the wrong one. I'm going to the top again.
punch. Sure. Cards in hand, too. Sure. You have one party maker? I'll drop it. I can sweep right now. I'm at 4 right now, I'm sorry. Sorry. No, not 2. That's not target myself. Triggers. Pass the turn to you. Yep. Okay. I'll respond to you. It's not good for
you. I know.
I'm going to put that card on the top of my library. It's on the right. I'm at 2.
You are. But you're going to win.
But I'm going to win. Right, this card's going on the top of my library. I'm going to go to my turn. Last round of creature match, so but it's got me thinking, you know. I have 4 cards in hand. Wow.
Top card to out.
I have 4.
Did you activate both forces?
I can only cast 1. You have 2 left. Alright, don't tell me. Don't tell me. Yeah. Let's talk about it after, for sure. I'm interested. I'm very interested. You do have a ton of mana there, for sure.
Yeah.
I guess maybe if you draw like a Lotus, and then you can play your hand down for double bridge. I don't know if you can get rid of your whole hand. I'm not sure. I don't know your deck. That was an insane game of Magic, though.
I guess we got to make a ton of decisions that felt really awesome.
Yeah, it's not how it needed to go for me.
No, no, that's definitely not how you wanted it.
You could have
not hit the mana source. You could have hit. I'm not sure that's right. I don't want to be results oriented, you know.
My thinking was, I had you in one turn, cutting off one mana.
I think you probably made the correct decision. I'm just saying that's probably a huge decision, you know, and it's definitely worth one like going back and thinking about. I might go back and look at it on stream later. It sounds really interesting. It's so weird because I'm used to seeing them all laid out and I have the mouse movement to, I'm laying in shops. I board these in, I board these out. And it's just like, it's been real weird. Can you tell me what happened now that I know your deck, or the cards I don't know?
Cards you don't know.
Okay.
I'll tell you
what happened.
It was 100% locked at that time. Just because I didn't do something.
Sure. Not that many viewers, but I finally broke my feature match losing streak when I went to Seattle the other weekend. Seth Mansfield finally. I got revenge on him too because I don't win against him very much. But I was just like, I lose a lot of feature matches. I finally beat it. I was like, I won the Grixis Delvermeer in Legacy, like super skill intensive, versus like one of the top 10 players in the world. It felt so good, and then just like immediately got paired down to lands. And I was like, there were only three Tenno's at that point, and I could have played either. There were two Grixis Delver players with me and Tenno, and so one of us got paired down. I got paired down, and I got paired down into lands. I got paired down against a very good lands player, and I don't play Legacy, so it was like even worse. Because like that thing is really like really odd. I like the kind of magic that's like not intuitive. Like I like playing like modern sometimes, like things that are like puzzles that are very they don't feel like magic. Like I play a lot of Anduin in modern, and it's like it's fun to figure out how to bounce these cards back and do that thing. But like lands, learning against playing against lands for the first time, it was hard. I can activate this Deathrend Shaman to get his land, and then he can cycle his thing into an crazy. My poor opponent was just like, he doesn't know what he's doing. I was like, you didn't pay for your Tabernacle. It's not Sacro, I'm just gonna destroy. And I was like, I like looked up in the head judge and like,
I've won games like that. Somebody had a mirror wedge out and just like Tabernacle.
Okay.
Alright. Yeah, I had no idea. Absolutely no idea. It's like who works cards like that? Yeah. I don't think it's my style of deck. It's a little odd. I think you need to know Legacy pretty well to play that deck too. I think Grixis Delver because it was like the most similar mechanics to like playing other decks that I've played. Like, I played like Blue Sky and Mach. It's like you're playing Magic, and if you know how to play Magic, like how you kind of learn to play Magic, then you can like do well with it. You can be on the play. Magic is fun. I wish there were more Vintage Twins. I have a lot of fun playing Vintage, but it's hard to justify playing a lot of Vintage when they're not that great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
anyway. I'm gonna write it down so we can talk about it after. You can tell me who's that way. Or if I'm smart. Or somewhere in the future. I mean, I was just having a discussion with my last feature mentor opponent, who was also on the Oscars. Talking about how mulliganing feels different in this format because your sixes can be much more powerful, but one card does seem to matter. So it's a balance because your sixes can be very, like, way stronger than your sevens, but you do have one card down. I like playing Magic, so I like winning, but like I don't come to this tournament particularly. To, I am trying to win this time, but the last two times, my first two TMDs, you played in 2003, so you might know. They're called Cerebral Assassin. So I played that in the last two TMDs because Dax is super sweet in this deck. So I was putting possessive portals into play and like shoot rooms and like bring back. It was so much fun. I went like I did okay the first time. The second time I like lost almost every round. Okay. Best of luck.
I'll probe you.
I'm gonna play a library of Alexandria. I'm gonna draw a card. I'm gonna play a block demo. I'm gonna play Soaring. I'm going down. I'm gonna play a block demo. I actually think I have to check. Yeah. Absolutely. I now have 5 cards up. Yeah. Got this place. Oh, I forgot we were supposed to use that last game. People were probably very confused.
I forgot,
honestly, so I'll be fixing this game. Yeah, I remember. They were probably like 2020. Works. Interesting. Okay.
So far behind was like.
All right. Yeah. Oh. Okay. Sure. So I use this. I have these. I drop a turn. I kind of like the Mox Up name. I couldn't get PO because if you name Soul Ring, then I can't cast PO.
I mean, I just had to hope that you didn't have a blue source. I think
I'm gonna cast myself. I pass the turn back. I have 7 cards. I drew another paradox.
Okay, that's.
Well, thanks for playing with me, man. Show on the screen so they know why.
Do you have 4 seconds?
Force this game?
No. I needed to draw Powder Peg or Machi. That was the.
You have won those game one?
That's what I did.
Okay. Yeah, that would have got a game. Would have been good. No. I countered. Do you have any other follow ups after that?
If I had any turn,
no. You, was this anything you could draw that turn? Turn that, like, I did all the things that you ever do and you had one draw. I don't think so. I mean, most of if you have one, you have one in your deck. I don't know what's in your deck, actually.
I don't have a careful listener. No, I don't have
a listener. Oh, okay.
I was wrong. It wasn't something I could have drawn there.
Okay. I was thinking about it. I was like, thinking about Vamp Tutor and going to 2 and like, how that could kill me.
I needed a.
Are you like Tangle Wire Stack kind of thing? Like Crucible and stuff? Okay, so I kept Mox, Soul Ring Library, Fetch, Island. All mana in a library.
Fine, what
if you and then I drew a Scroll. I mean, Scroll found me actually. I'm getting guaranteed one draw off library.
I agree that that's a good
idea. Because it's just, it's a little awkward because I want to play these before you play a sphere type effect, but I want to keep library. But like, you're like the wasteland, so it's like, I play library, get a draw off my library, and then if it doesn't work out, I can just play all my lands. I just don't have an action, but like, I guess your deck, which probably has, what, 4 ways in the mind, which will. I like want all those sort of fans, which I
guess. Yeah, my game plan against outgoing walls.
I struck roughly about 4:30 swords.
I crushed the card.
Yeah.
If I don't hit one of those.
Well, you didn't get to see.
That's spicy.
It's been great today. It's so much fun. So, I just poured a bunch of free calls.
Probably. I want to play this shots.
first draft of the world.
That's cool. Round one in game three was just against Shops. It was just steering bridge, bottle closer, go. Turn two, steering bridge. No, no, turn two and three were in something like the best.
That's all I triggers.
Yeah, you get to ancestral every turn, and you get to ramp up stacks to like six because
that sounds like a that sounds like a lot of. I'm not a big Shops guy, but that sounds like a lot of fun to me.
I know it's amazing.
Do you play this online?
So easy to play.
Just like I guess I just came up.
You knock me out of
a
challenge.
All those challenges blend together now. So many rounds.
This is a wild
one. Okay. Yeah, I'm not playing my PO version. I usually play the podcast for like Will and stuff, but I just thought it was a little bit worse than the one the European guys are playing.
I want to. So the reason I'm playing is if I'm playing two out of Texas matchup, I'm running into a lot more
I love C, but C is a dangerous game.
It is.
I just like Thoughtcast a lot more. This one's like a more control. Like you have like library and like these big spells. I was a little bit more like I like to play the kind of like just go, you know. But nice to meet you. Absolutely.
Yeah, it was really fun.
Next time I see you online, I'll remember.
Sure.
Hey man, see you in the top 8. Just went out.
Good. I think my round three.
Oh, tell me. I want to hear.
We have 3 minutes before turns.
Okay.
What
are you playing?
Dredge. I had two sphere of resistance. You know, two sphere of light. I never shot him before. I'm using one. So I'm keeping him off. I'm keeping him off of 3 mana every turn.
Okay.
Dredge isn't bothering most of us. So he's out. The thing is, I only got one way killing him
for
3 turns.
Yeah,
I played the Ballista. I have a ton of mana. I waited for Senko. I forget to burn him.
No!
Yeah, that was. That's why it's kind of hard.
What did he get to do?
He could play Ninja Tree or Ballista, assuming that it's drawn out. That's exactly right. But I had the Academy in the way. I was just dumping artifacts every time.
How does Hollow look in this period? Like, maybe you can just get to like
more cards. I was hoping to play against Dredd and John today. It's 14 in my sideboard.
Yeah, I mean, that's how sideboards are built, right? I have 6 graveyard cards. That's on the low side, so 10.
Yeah, but, I mean, it matters less when you're playing a combo game.
Doing it.
I think you're gonna get this up.
7 rounds?
I need to win more rounds. I need to.
2 more rounds. 7 rounds. Like, 3 more rounds total. Yeah.
3 more rounds total. So I need to what?
You need to win out, I think. Because you're 1-1. You're 2-1.
I can't
1-1.
4-2.
I don't even. You won't even be able to. Yeah, you have to win out because you've got a draw. You got to win, and then you win. Theoretically, you lost your last
round. That's why that penguin is going to win that tie.
Yeah, it's something that's weird because you can't do that. You can't draw. Potentially draw.
Yep, exactly.
It happened to me once. I was in one of the vintage challenges. I started 4-0, lost my last two, and lost on rainbow. Which should never happen, technically. But like, because it's such a small player pool, like, weird shit can happen.
I was top of the four ones, then I went 4-2, I was in 17. So I didn't even get the money back. I love
getting my money. So that's the best thing about those challenges is you can go 2-4 and get your money back sometimes. I did that once. I made a horrible deck, went 2-4 and got my money back. It's the greatest thing ever.
Yeah.
So you beat up some shop players.
Two hundred instances.